We're on. Hi.
Hi.
Hello, world.
Hi. Hello. Hi. I'm David Fickus, and this is... Wait, Bryce, I don't think we should start the show yet. I've seen a couple of these things where we should kind of, like, pause a little bit and let people show up, because it's like, you know, like the idea of holding curtain. Let's not start right away. Let's, like, let it go for a moment.
Okay, but... It's started. We're on camera.
Yeah, but let's not start yet.
But we have started.
So let me see how many followers or people are looking real quick. So let me know when we're going to start.
We got one more since you last checked.
There we are. Okay. It's coming. Okay. So let me know when you want to start.
I mean... We've started. We already did it.
It's really starting like a full. It's starting to feel like a real, like, this is a bit.
It's a real bit.
It's a bit. Okay, we can stop the bit and start the show in a second.
As in not now.
Let's not do it yet. Let's wait for the crowd.
Okay.
Oh wow, the graphics look good, Bryce.
Thanks.
You went with an 80s kind of a Punch-Out vibe there. I like it.
Yeah.
That's good.
Our offline movie night, online edition.
So we're starting?
I don't know. I'm we're on. Gotta say
hi,
something.
Hi, and welcome to offline movie night online. I'm David Fickus, and this is Bryce Beckham, and collectively, we're Drama 3-4. It's strange days, guys. It's strange days. So for those of you who don't know, we've been doing a campaign basically called 34 Days of Drama 3-4. And this is day 20. So for 20 days, we've been posting highlights and also premieres and all kinds of crazy stuff on our page. You know, you may be watching this embedded on our page right now, drama34.com/34days. If you want to chat along and type in questions and talk to us that way during the show, I would click over to the YouTube live link, which would be great. And Tara just asked what we were drinking. I'm having a rum and coke because.
And again, I can explain if you are watching on drama34.com/34days, and you would like to be part of the chat on YouTube live, you can just click the title of the video on the video player, and it'll take you straight to the page.
So, what is Offline Movie Night? Offline Movie Night, a few years ago, we decided that short films should not only be viewed on your computer, and they should be with an audience and a crowd, and let's get people together, and let's do what Drama 3-4 has always done, which is...
feel their hot breath on our necks.
Yeah, that's not a thing right now, mm-hmm. And as we were showcasing some of the shows that we've done over our campaign, we were like, we should probably do Offline Movie Night. We've done I Made You a Mixtape, we're going to do a couple other things. A couple days ago, on Tuesday, on Monday. When was that?
That was Monday.
On Monday night, we premiered Marisa Coughlin's film that we produced, Fulfillment. So that's up with a live chat, Kevin Heffernan and Marisa Coughlin, which was really fun. I hope you guys check that out. If you haven't, feel free to watch that. Not right now, because you're watching this. We should point out that, yes, we are dealing with technical things. If for some reason my internet gets goofy or Bryce's internet gets goofy, which is out of our control, just please forgive us. If for some reason we lose the signal, go to the drama34.com/34days to find the new signal or the new link.
Or just our YouTube account, just our homepage of our YouTube.
Yeah, and that's it. Also, Save with Stories. We want to, that was the fundraiser that Marisa Coughlin pointed us out to. And we raised some money for that. It's a really awesome organization where they're reading books for children while everyone's in quarantine. It's Amy Adams and Jennifer Garner's organization. So I really think you guys should check that out. Tara Jayn from Natalie and Tara Try Stuff and John Mattingly are in our chat. They're going to be like doing some links and pointing you at the direction of both the fundraiser. We have a Venmo. You can directly just kind of buy a ticket or donate to us, and we will make that donation on your behalf. That's at Drama34Prod for Venmo. And then what else, Bryce? We're going to watch movies. We're going to watch some shorts.
Yeah, we're going to watch a bunch of shorts.
Yeah. Okay, so should we talk about some of the people involved. We have a premiere of Leonora Gershman Pitts's. So I still say the Gershman sometimes. Well, there's a premiere of Leonora Pitts's film, Like Holy Wine. Leah Richardson and Sean Hamrin. We're going to show one of theirs. We're going to show some Michael Horowitz and some Gareth Smith and some Jenny Lee and some Liam Sullivan and some Drama 3-4 stuff and some Charles, which I'm very excited about, the Charles one. I don't know. What else? We got a whole lineup. There's four chunks. Get comfortable for four chunks of short films. Yeah. So
each one is about, I mean, the overall runtime of the show is going to be about an hour and a half. Probably a little more with the rate that we're rambling.
With the thickest blabbermouth.
Yeah. So you know, settle in, get comfortable, get a drink now while we're talking before we start the films.
Yes.
Get whatever you want, snack and drinks wise, because when you know once we start, then you're not going to want to miss those.
No, you're gonna enjoy the crap out of it. We should say, as we put together this program, I was realizing there was a couple of like, oh, why did we pick all the ones where everyone's going outside? There's a lot of wilderness and outside stuff. Yeah. And there is a little, for those of you guys, well, I should say, it's kind of comedic. There's some bloody stuff.
There's actually quite a bit of blood in
and
this.
And as far as like real blue humor, we're saving some of that stuff for other days, right? No, yeah, there's some stuff.
There's some stuff.
Listen, we put Deliverance the musical out yesterday. Like that.
That's about as.
Now that's
blue
a short.
As, yeah, that's about as blue as we have gotten.
Yeah. Anyway.
Yeah.
Okay, so to recap, Save With Stories is a charity we're going to raise some money for. At Drama34Prod is our Venmo. So we got a bunch of films. We have four chunks coming up. We'll watch them. Hopefully the filmmakers who are all watching in the chat are going to let us know where to find information on them. Tara's doing some of that stuff. John Mattingly's doing some of that stuff. But now we get to sit back and relax and watch some flicks.
Yeah,
right.
And we'll be back after the first chunk to kind of tee up the next thing and you know have a quick breather. But so settle in for about 20 minutes of chunk one.
Yeah, here's chunk one, people. Enjoy.
The river has run dry. The fish are gone. The beasts will be hungry.
May I help you?
We must be cautious not to tread in their domain.
What is it?
It's too hot.
As well as I, the beast will strike again.
And we must strike back!
Let me warm it up.
too soft. I don't know what's happening to me.
Speak with old man Gary. He'll know what to do.
Run!
You don't want to love me. What are you doing here?
It's my house. Is it?
It's just right.
They're bears! They're werebears there!
Who's been sleeping in my bed?
You must share her.
I will not.
You have no choice.
Papa, I love you.
You broke my chair, you little...
What do you know of the werebears?
I love you. I don't care what you are.
How many are there? Two? Four? More than two, but less than four? Tell me!
I don't know anything. Please, I'm so hungry. Do you have any...
porridge?
California Dreaming with Don Dimmel is made possible through a grant from the Chester M. Arthur Foundation.
Hi, I'm Don Dimmel.
I'm Don Dimmel.
We have driven down, I think, the windiest road I've ever been on. I'm a little dizzy from the ride over. 7 hours to get here. The longest, windiest road. Four different freeways. Really windy road. But it is worth it to be here now in beautiful and historic Garvin, Chino, Upland, Moda, Bell Gardens. Well, here we are. We have hooked up with...
Park Ranger Chip Dooley.
And your job here is?
Park Ranger.
And your name is?
Chip Dooley.
And what is it you do around these parts?
I'm a park ranger.
And what do people call you?
Chip Dooley.
Wow, so all of this is just wild grass.
Yep.
Yeah, see if you can get a shot of this, Langdon. There's wild grass over there, and there's wild grass over there, and there's... Well, what is that over there, though?
Wild grass.
Oh, so that is wild grass. So it's not just wild grass. There's a lot of rich history here.
No, it's just wild grass. If you're confused about anything that you see, I would say there's a 98% chance that it is wild grass.
Well, I guess that's probably why they call it Wild Grass State Park.
Oh yeah.
And what was it before it was wild grass?
Like millions of years ago?
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, I don't know. I'm not a scientist. I mainly just watch the parking lot.
So, volcanoes, probably.
Maybe.
So there were volcanoes all around here, just all over. We could be standing on a volcano right now.
Well, yeah, well, not now.
Hundreds of years ago.
Millions.
So if we were here last Tuesday, this would all be volcanoes.
No.
What if we came here last Monday? So let me ask you this, Ranger. Is this the sort of place you like to go when you just want to relax and unwind?
Oh, no. I'm actually allergic to wild grass. So this is actually very difficult for me to be around. So if you are also allergic to wild grass, be sure to take a Zyrtec. Or a Benadryl.
Or don't come at all. Stay away from this place.
Maybe don't come.
Well, it's all wild grass now, but hundreds of years ago.
Millions of years
ago. This was all hot lava.
Maybe.
Just imagine it with coconuts and hot girls and everybody surfing, safari.
That also not true. I think that's a song.
I'm Don Dimmel, and this is California Dreamin'.
Hi, I'm Jeff Wiens. I'm reading for the part of Roger Murtaugh for Lethal Weapon. Hi, I'm Jeff Wiens, reading for Martin Riggs for Lethal Weapon.
Okay, no bullshit! You wanna kill yourself? Shut up! Yes or no? You wanna die?
Oh, I got the job done!
Just answer the question!
Oh, what do you wanna hear from me, man? That sometimes I think about eating a bullet? Well, I do. I got a special one for the occasion with a hollow point mixer that blows the back of my goddamn head. I do the job right. Every day, man, I think of a reason why not to do it. Every single day. And you want to know why I don't? This is going to make you laugh. The job. Doing the job. That's the reason.
You want to die?
I'm not afraid of it. No.
Here, take my gun. Don't nibble on the barrel. Pull the trigger. Go ahead if you're serious.
You shouldn't tempt me, man.
In your mouth. The bullet might go through your ear and not kill you.
Under the chin's just as good.
You're not trying to draw psycho pension. You really are crazy.
I'm hungry. I'm gonna go get something to eat.
Oh, I'm too old for this shit.
Well, Tom, I hope you like board games.
Sir, I would really be honored to ask for your daughter's hand in marriage.
You know, Vera's mom is looking down at us from heaven. She's with Jesus. So I hope for your sake you don't stink. Because this is a family tradition, and we play to win.
He's serious, Tom.
You go first. Okay, thank you, sir.
Tom, no one ever beats him. Win, Tom. Win, please.
You know you get 50 bonus points if you use all your letters in one turn.
Oh. Tom, please.
Ah, jeez. You know, jeez is just short for Jesus. And that's taking the Lord's name in vain.
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Respect Jesus. Jesus Christ. I got your back.
Wad. W-A-D, wad.
It's kind of disgusting, Tom.
No, like a wad of gum. It's a lot better than what... Never mind.
Okay, well, not a lot of points there, Tom. I've got one. What? As in, what are your intentions with my daughter, punk?
Dad, please. He tried to ask you already. Okay, I have one. But.
But?
Yes, Dad, but. Like a person's bottom.
But that's French.
No, it's not, Dad.
You say that word and then you say, pardon my French. Right, Tom?
It's worth 12 points, Dad.
Oh, so it is. Well, good job. Tom, your turn.
Oh, come on.
Vera, remind me in the morning to call the deacon's office. I want to get those Bibles rebound. All of them.
Oh, man.
I don't like a loose Bible.
Tom.
Tom, your turn.
Tuck. Tuck. T-U-C-K. Tuck.
Tuck.
Like, tuck you into bed at night. Not that I've ever done that with your...
Uh-huh. Okay. I have AIDS.
Dad, don't say that.
What? AIDS. Helps. It's not the awareness kind.
Sex.
You put down butt and then you put down sex?
Yeah. Like what you do when you want to stay a virgin.
I don't get it. Do you know what she's talking about?
I got 41 points, Dad.
Oh, good. Wow. Good job, Vera. Go ahead, Tom.
Oh, man. Wow. Rafting. Rafting. R-A-F-T-I-N-G. Rafting.
Yay!
Would have been better with white water in front of it.
There's not enough tiles to...
Don't argue with me, Tom.
You know what? I thought it was pretty good, considering what I have been looking at.
Dong.
Dad? Hmm? Dong is another word for penis.
That is toilet talk. Now flush it. Flush it and wipe.
As in dick, or schlong, or cock!
I'm gonna get those scrub-free bubbles. Pour them right in your mouth. I don't have to do anything. They do all the work. I've seen him on TV.
As in something I've been very familiar with since I was 16, but you don't want to know about it.
No, no, as in ding dong. Ding dong, who's there? Family fun. Family fun. I'm winning, by the way.
Well, I've got nothing this turn but poo.
You're gonna make me do the exorcism, aren't you?
Everyone poos, Dad! It's a book, for fuck's sake!
I'm gonna tie you to the bed. I'm gonna tie you to the bed, and I'm gonna exorcise the demons out of your mouth!
Everyone fucks too,
you
Dad!
You gutter slut. You gutter whore.
You
gutter
do
trash.
This every time we play
I'm gonna put
Scrabble.
You out with the trash and the recycling.
I'm gonna run away!
I'm gonna get those
I'm
demons out of
27 years old, for
out,
fuck's
out.
Sake!
Demons out!
Jism slap!
What is a jism slap, son? It's when you come in your hand and slap your girlfriend's ass. It's a loving gesture between two consenting adults.
Oh, wow.
You wouldn't believe the letters I've been getting here, sir. You just put down the word jism slap. You know what that says to me? That you're a winner. That you'll do whatever it takes to win. And that's what I'm looking for. You used all your letters, and that's a triple word score. Great job, Tom. Great job?
See, Dad, I told you you'd like him.
I just played jism slap. Go on upstairs and jism slap my daughter. You earned it.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
And we're back.
And we are back.
And we're back.
Welcome to a segment we'd like to call, What the Hell Did We Just Watch? We'll work backwards. Okay, that was Dirty Scrabble, starring Liam Sullivan, Liam Sullivan, and Liam Sullivan. We love Liam, obviously. He's in a lot of stuff we do. That was one of his movies. He's in a lot of our movies. We all collaborate. I love that. Kills me every time I like revisiting it.
It's a good one.
Yeah.
I love how we were just saying how like this one doesn't get very blue.
Oh yeah. Never mind. You're right. And Box of Gold had some like, you know, girl on girl action with payslip and
yeah.
And
yeah. So there was plenty in there that we could have
I was focusing more on the possums or whatever. Okay, so also just on that, that was part one of Possum Death Spree. So hold on to
There's more to come.
There's more to come. So you get the full flashback saga of Gareth Smith and Mike Horowitz's epic Adam Films adventure, Possum Death Spree. I can't say that. Possum Death Spree. My mom just sent me a thing about my speech impediment in kindergarten. Also, I was too active in kindergarten, and it was labeled as still difficult on my report card. That's a...
What?
Sidebar. It's a sidebar. Never mind.
When you say just sent you, like, did she send you that?
Cleaning out stuff earlier, and they sent me my report card from kindergarten.
I see.
And they said, uses self-control, still difficult. I thought that was hilarious. Anyway.
Very interesting.
We watched Jeff Wiens audition for Lethal Weapon,
mm-hmm.
which is something we shot at the old Drama 3-4 offices. I don't even know. We didn't do that as there was a new Lethal Weapon coming, right?
No, we didn't know that. We just did that for the hell of it.
And ironically, Colin Patrick Lynch, Flozzlsnoff, who is Don Dimmel.
Flozzlsnoff.
I think he is in the pilot of Lethal Weapon, the new Lethal Weapon. Also, at one point, Terrence Winter from Basement in the Kitchen worked on that show. And so there's a lot of Riggs and Murtaugh crossover.
Basement
in
the Kitchen is coming later in the 34 days.
Yes, I'm wearing a shirt today, by the way.
I'm wearing a shirt that's this is an IT joke for anyone who's ever set up a modem or a Wi-Fi router.
Anyway. I mean, that's most of our audience. And then we started with Locked of Gold, which was our parody of Red Riding Hood. When that came out,
right.
It was very... That was our push on
Amanda Seyfried.
And ours was starring the amazing Allison Hayslip, who was chatting along.
Right.
Okay, so should we get on to the second chunk? Is there anything I was going to talk about? Oh, I was laughing about how Locks of Gold also shot in the Arboretum. Yesterday we showed Deliverance shot in the Arboretum, which also in the blog has a link and I can't believe you put that up, but you can click on my Fabio, A Time for Romance, also shot in the Arboretum. I really have had one drink, but I think it's just one.
Maybe you want to slow down.
You're right. Good point.
Is there anything coming up in Chunk 2 that we want to set up right
well,
now?
Well, I do think we do have... Well, we'll talk about Dead Ted afterwards, and we'll talk about Natalie and Tara and Jason's movie afterwards. But what we will talk about beforehand is Leah Richardson and Sean Hamrin, which we're going to start this chunk with that. This is something they just made.
So very
this is
timely.
Probably the most recent thing. They posted it on, you guys should find their Instagrams and stuff like that. Tara, you can, and John, put that in the chatty chat. But we're going to start with some quarantine comedy. So it's a new thing, guys. It's happening all over the nation. God.
Okay. All right, here we go.
Chunk 2.
Shouldn't we be inside?
Nah, it's fine.
This is all I can find.
Did you know it paralyzes your lungs?
You know there's fatal cases for people in their 30s?
You know it's so contagious no one can visit you in the hospital and you're alone on your deathbed?
You want to get a coffee?
Yeah.
The first case in our neighborhood was just reported.
Apparently you can live on surfaces for up to 72 hours.
The US has more cases than China.
Cut me in. Let me know when I'm in.
All right, we are we're on. It's going to take a while to catch up. So,
okay,
you're on.
We're on. Hi, we're on. So, is Adam Films still a thing? Listen, I think we were getting some stuff regarding posting Possum Death Spree on YouTube. So they're I guess extra. I mean, we have the owner's permission, I think, unless Adam Films. I don't know. So we are doing some technical difficulties. This is exactly what we said. You know, if we had technical difficulties, we'd have to work with it. But apparently, we got a notice from Possum Death Spree being something that we can't air. So Bryce is doing. Are you online? Are they visually seeing you too, Bryce? Because
yeah, they're seeing me.
I'm not seeing. It just says stream unavailable.
I know it'll catch up.
How far behind are we? I think it might be. I think we may have to do a new link, right? I'm not.
I don't know. I don't know how to re.
Ugh, so annoying. People are chatting. Should I go over there?
I mean, it says temporarily blocked.
Temporarily blocked.
So when I removed, I would think it would come back.
This is crazy. This is fun stuff that we're learning about,
yeah,
right?
Because if we did come back, they're going to see all of this. But
yeah.
This seems like too much delay.
I'm looking at the live feed right now, and it just
now says it's no longer blocked.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it just now checked.
Okay. Is it picking back up? So how do we do this?
I don't know how I... Do I need to start?
Oh, maybe I have to revamp it. Hold on. Let me see if I re...
Oh, there we are. There we are. We're up.
I'm back up?
Yep.
Is it behind?
I can't tell.
We don't know what we're watching right now. So basically, if this is new information to you, YouTube stopped something because we were... Tara Jane just said you're back.
Yeah.
But is it... I don't know at what point this is, but this is hilarious. Okay, so what do we do? Ahead? We just don't show Possum Desperate,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we can't show Possum Desperate.
Okay, which means here's what we can do. Here's what we can do.
We can play Stickbone 12.
Okay, we can go do Stickbone 12 and go into the rest of that chunk. Did you just fast forward to that chunk?
No, I'm going to have to play the movies individually, which means I have to set them up while they're going.
Okay.
What was
so chunk four is fine because it doesn't have Possum Death Spree. So anyway, just if you guys are just tuning in because there was a disruption, basically we think there was a copyright claim on Possum Death Spree from Adam Films. Apparently still a thing? I don't know. Mike, we may have to have a whole copyright talk about that. Anyway, so... We are going to skip ahead. The mystery of Possum Death Spree will always haunt you. And we'll figure out how we can get you guys to the end of that movie. But Bryce, are you ready, queued up to kind of individually do the remainder of chunk two?
I'm at least the next one. And then we can talk while that's
playing. We'll figure it out. Okay, yeah. Let's play some stuff. Go for it, Bryce.
Here we go.
And we're back.
Dad, it's me, your Uncle Bert.
Uncle Bert?
Yeah.
Oh, you scared me. Wow. I can't believe I'm dead.
Ugh.
What?
I dyed in this dumb shirt. People are gonna find me in this.
Take a look at what you're wearing now, Ted. You're stuck in that shirt forever.
What?
Ghosts wear the clothes that they died in for eternity.
Oh, no.
Why are you wearing that to begin with?
All my clothes were dirty, so I just borrowed my dad's shirt.
Ted!
Hayden?
Ted?
Hayden.
Ted, how are you feeling?
She can't see or hear you.
Oh my God, Ted! Teddy bear, I thought you were gone.
In case I go out again, I need you to put new clothes on me.
What?
Just, please.
Yeah, no, okay, yeah, whatever you need, just rest.
Naked in front of everybody forever.
What do you mean everybody?
This is an old house. A lot of people have died here, Ted.
Look at you, you're naked. Sorry. I didn't mean to scare you. I'm gonna go now.
That's like a life experience.
Shut up, Tam.
Hello?
Hey, Alice?
Yes.
We
signal again?
Tammy, I didn't have signal at the campsite. Why would I have signal now?
What if?
Fine. Nothing.
You know, this reminds me of the Q3 disaster at work. Remember, I told you everyone was freaking out because the Maitland file was lost, but because of my color-coded filing system, everything worked out.
Tammy, does anyone die in the story?
Well, no.
Then what does it have to do with the current situation?
If you remember, everyone was giving me a hard time for using office hours to roid debug my filing system, but because of it, I knew that teal was in the wrong place. It was next to tangerine, and everyone knows that green is never next to orange, even when you're using a tertiary.
Oh, ah, ah, Jesus, what?
Ah, it's a bug! Bug, bug, bug!
God,
oh,
no.
Check me!
Wait, you're okay. You're okay. Okay. Let's take a break. Is there any jerky left?
No.
A granola bar?
No.
God, I am so hungry! This is a horrible idea. We aren't camping people. Only camping people should go camping. I can't believe I let you talk me into this.
Talk you into this? The hike was your idea. I wanted to pan for gold.
There is no gold.
I saw this video on YouTube of these two girls and they...
I don't have the energy to go through this again with you. There is no gold. Look, I am cold and I am hungry and I could have sworn there was another granola bar left.
I thought we would run into somebody by now. I mean, how big can Yosemite actually be?
Okay, let's think about this logically. Someone has got to be looking for us. We were supposed to be back in LA last night. Tom will have realized that something's wrong by now, and you're probably missed at work. Tammy, is that the last of the toilet paper? Damn it, Tammy! Okay, now we have no food and no toilet paper. We're gonna die out here.
We're not gonna die out here. We've got this. It's only been 2 days. Somebody is going to find us. Okay, the last time we looked at the map, it said the road would be that way.
The last time we looked at the map?
No, that way?
You were right the first time, Tammy. The last time we looked was yesterday. We could have been walking in circles for all we know.
I thought that tree looked familiar.
It's a tree, Tammy. They all look the same.
Well, if you hadn't have lost the map...
I didn't lose the map. I'm certain you had it last.
Well, it's a good thing I brought the panic button.
Funny.
If things get any worse, I say we use it.
If things get any worse? Tammy, we have been lost in the woods for 2 days. It's getting dark again. I am starving. How could it possibly get any worse?
Well, then I vote we use it now.
Can you be serious for 10 seconds?
I am.
There is no such thing as a panic button.
Oh, yeah? What is this then?
It's a piece of paper with a circle drawn on it.
It says panic button right there.
Yeah, but I mean in your handwriting.
I know, I made it.
It's, it's not even a button. You can't even push it. It can't be a button if it's not raised. A button has but one requirement. It must be pushable.
Oh, okay.
I can't believe I am explaining a button to you.
Okay, I've got it. I am going to add shadowing into the new design, giving it a raised effect, implying a push.
You can't imply a push. You have to actually be able to push it. That is the definition of a button.
So what, I should make an actual button? That would put my cost to the roof.
Your cost? It doesn't matter. It's not an actual button. It doesn't do anything.
You haven't even tried it yet.
You don't have to try it.
You are such a naysayer. You know that? You never respect any of my inventions.
What inventions? You don't invent.
If I did, I'm saying.
Timmy, this is an absurd conversation. You don't invent.
What about the panic button?
It's just a piece of paper.
What about the map?
What?
You never gave the map any respect either. I spent days making that thing.
Wait, you made the map?
Yes, and I could have gotten into a lot of trouble for laminating that at work, and all you could say was, this map must be wrong. We should have hit the road by now. This map got us lost.
You made the map!
Or what about when you said we probably would be better off without the map? How do you think that made me feel?
I don't care how it made you feel, Tammy! We are lost in the woods because of you! I am gonna die in the woods because of you! Do you understand that?
Calm down, we still have the panic button.
It's not a button, Tammy. See, you stupid twit, it doesn't do a thing. It's a crappy drawing.
You did it wrong.
What?
You did it wrong. You were pushing it wrong. You gotta go. Click, click.
I'm leaving.
No, come on!
I'm leaving. I'm going that way. This is all your fault! You always do this to us! I can't... I stand a better chance on my own. I hope you get eaten by a bear!
You don't mean that. Alice, just push the panic...
Oh my God! If you say panic button one more time, I will kill you myself! Don't follow me!
Click.
Hey, I found him. Yeah, I see him.
Hey! Over here! Hey, Alice! Oh, I did have a granola bar.
I hate you.
And we're back. Well, that was interesting. Things we learned while we were gone. Turns out, I think there is the old Adam Films from 2000-something. Apparently, they still have a copyright claim on that. And so that is what caused a little mayhem, as well as our song Stickbone 12 that was part of I Hate My 30s, but the music video wasn't officially, I don't know. Which brings up a whole long story of how our original YouTube page got shut down years ago because Viacom told us to promote our television show. Yeah, they told us to put it on the television show, or put it on the YouTubes to do the promotions. And
get it out there, guys.
Yeah, and then Viacom made its own claim against us and killed our page. Genius.
It's all automated. They don't know what's happening.
That was years ago, and here we are again. We also watched Leah Richardson and Sean Hamrin's movie. We watched some of Possum Death Spree. We were going to show part three. We're going to skip that now. We're going to find a way to let you guys see that. Dead Ted. That was Jonathan Wiggs from The Dark Room, who has served us many drinks and was going to do a film festival premiere. And he sent me the movie, and I was excited to share it. And his girlfriend, Jordan Rader, as the director. And I think it got a little sticky in there. So there is a Vimeo link that Tara is going to put out there, or I sent that to you, Tara. It's on the spreadsheet. We should get that link so you can watch that because I know there was, I think there was some jittery stuff. And then we watched Sneaky Pineapple's Panic Button, which is a favorite of ours. And I always get so excited about that short. Bryce, how are you? I just did a lot of talking.
I'm fine. I'm kind of laughing at some of the freeze frames I'm getting over here when you when your signal locks
up
for a second.
So I'm getting more technical difficulties on my end?
Yeah, I mean your sound keeps coming through, so I think you're fine.
It's the reverse of that Fletch joke. Anyway. Or is it Spies Like Us? Spies Like Us. Spies Like Us. Never mind. Moving on.
I don't even know what joke you're talking about.
But he talks like that. I won't do it.
Oh, right, yeah.
Okay, so now, chunk three, we have a world premiere of Leonora Pitts' film.
It has been to one or two festivals already.
Yes, yes.
But this will be the first time it's ever been online, and obviously it's not going to stay there. We're not going to leave this up indefinitely, so...
Yes, it still has a festival run when festivals are a thing in its future. But we wanted to give you guys a little premiere and let people see this work. Bryce and I did the post-production on this, and this is our fourth collaboration with Leonora. It's our millionth collaboration, but with her as a director, this is our fourth collaboration with her. And we want to start this chunk with that, and then we'll watch some more movies and we'll chat about that before chunk four. So. Good?
All right.
Everybody, ladies and gentlemen, like holy wine.
That was good. It was tasty.
Thanks.
Was that turmeric?
Turmeric?
Whatever, yeah, was that it?
Yeah, I never know how to say it either.
Yeah, that's good.
No, it's in there, yeah. I'm not ready to go.
I can't do this anymore.
Please don't be mean to me.
I'm not being mean. It's just I'm making the best decision for the both of us.
What is it that you can't do anymore?
This just feels very familiar to me. Someone sitting here disappointed in me because of their needs. Sulking.
I mean, you just broke up with me. I think I'm allowed to be sad.
Don't think of it as a breakup. And I told you, I just want to be alone. I don't know how to make that any more clear.
Right, but if you're alone, then that means that we're not together, which makes this, in essence, a breakup.
Please don't do those dishes.
They're just gonna rot if I don't do them.
Please.
Fine, I won't.
This is broken.
So let's mend it.
No, this is broken.
That was kind of dramatic.
Well, but...
You get a new freckle right there.
I think it's an age spot.
Your dress is very pretty.
Thank you. I bought it special. I had different expectations of how this night was going to go.
This actually reminds me of that cab we had at Dave and Betty's wedding.
Mm. The one I barfed up.
Barfed up. Yeah.
Into your lap.
Yes. Look, we've talked this to death. I told you at the beginning of the night that I just need to be alone. I've said it again and again.
I'm just scared. I'm scared to leave this place. And I'm scared that whatever I say to you is gonna be the last thing that I ever say to you. Will you just give me 2 minutes? Just to get it all out.
Try to find a reason. try to find a reason.
California Dreaming with Don Dimmel is made possible through a grant from the Chester M. Arthur Foundation.
Hi, I'm Don Dimmel.
I'm Don Dimmel.
And this is California.
California.
California
Dreaming. Here, we've hooked up now with, well, I'm not sure, how would you say, what do you call a lady ranger?
Ranger.
All right, so docent, would that be the correct term, Dan?
No, just Ranger.
And so we are here with Lady Ranger Willoughby.
No, don't need, there's no distinction.
All right, okay. So Lady Ranger.
No lady in front of it. Ranger. Man, woman, Ranger. Just Ranger.
Right, so Lady Ranger Willoughby.
No, that's not it. Yeah, you don't have to make a distinction from a male ranger and a female ranger.
Oh, so you're sort of in between is what you're saying.
No, that's not what I'm saying.
We are here with Lady Ranger Willoughby.
No, it's just Willoughby. Ranger Willoughby.
I see. So it's like Spanish.
No.
Where are the adjectives?
Mm-mm. It's not Spanish. There's no distinction. It's Ranger Willoughby. No lady in front of it.
No lady in front of it. What about if it's a female woman?
Ranger.
Same rule applies.
Same rule.
Mm-hmm. So it is docent.
No.
And so you do all the cooking and the cleaning.
No.
And the darning of the socks.
What?
And if the other rangers, the real rangers come in
no,
and
no,
sometimes.
No. Okay. I'm a real ranger.
Yeah, a real female lady ranger.
Male and female rangers are equal. So there's no hierarchy.
I see. So it is gender-based.
Not no, it's not. This is ranger.
I see. I told.
I don't think you do.
No, I think if you give me a second, it will catch up. So does anyone clean the bathrooms? Because at some point, I'm going to have to use the little boy's room.
Well, yeah, I mean, I clean the bathrooms, but that's just purely budgetary, you know? It doesn't have nothing to do with gender.
Oh, so is that the correct term then? Gender?
Correct term for what?
Instead of woman. Do you normally wear a skirt? Because I think that's maybe what is confusing me.
What? No, these are just regulation uniforms. So there's no...
Oh, I thought for a second maybe it was like the Sadie Hawkins dance where, you know, the women come dressed up as male rangers sometimes.
I don't think that's what happens at those dances.
That's what happened at mine.
That explains a lot.
And then we're going to try this one more time here. We are here with Ms. Lady Ranger Willoughby the Third.
No.
And she's going to be our female gender non-binary explainer person today.
Okay. No.
She also cleans the bathroom. She's the bathroom cleaner person, but we want to be clear. She's doing that not because of her job, but because she's just a nice person.
Yeah, sure. Mm-hmm.
And we're back!
We're back!
We're back!
That was chunk three, minus some possums. Working backwards, a little more Don Dimmel, the Colin Lynch, and some Pam Cooke. He's got a whole series of those, so everyone check them out. They're very funny. He does a lot of fun stuff. You guys should all be following Colin's stuff. Flozzlsnoff. And what else did we watch?
Sounds like a curse word that a conservative Christian would use. Oh, Flozzlsnoff.
Flozzlsnoff. We also watched High Wire, which is from Gareth Smith and Jenny Lee.
To Be Free.
Sorry, To Be Free. I kept calling it High Wire because. Obviously, there's high wires in it. I made a joke to Bryce, too. I was like, oh, look, that's how we're all going to be social distancing up in the sky on wires. it's such an amazing thing. They were talking about that for a while, and I love that they put that together. There's another short film that we screened at the last live online offline movie night where the signs all come crashing down, and it's this great digital stuff. And also, you know, Gareth, Jenny and Gareth are amazing, and they're part of Possum Death Spree as well, and they also did all the stuff I Hate My 30s, which you saw most of with Stickbone 12. But, you know. And then we opened that chunk with Leonora Pitts's Like Holy Wine. We hope you enjoyed that. It was Matthew Del Negro was in that, and he is also in Tammy Minoff's movie Limerence, which is now streaming on Amazon Prime, which we also did the trailer for, which you can see in our post-batch. So it's fun. We were working on two things with Matthew, and we had never met him, which is fun. I met him later, which is fun, too. Anyway, so we have one final chunk. The last movie may have some flagging issues musically. Maybe not. So if that gets messed up, we'll jump right in. We have a movie from Charles in this chunk. We have some Franco and Billy. But first... a word from our sponsor.
And now, TV personality Bob Tulap with a very special message from one of our sponsors.
Do you have the copy for Do you have the copy for the third one there?
Hi, this is Bob Tulap, and if you're like me, you're thinking of retirement. God knows that's true. All right, take it again. Hi, Bob Tulap here, and if you're like me, you're thinking of retirement. it's time to buy an RV. Recreational vehicle, that is. And why not get the best? Get a Capricorn Double Wide RV. Capricorn Double Wide RVs come with stereo, DVD player, a queen-size bed, and wheels. Wheels? Oh, great, you told me they come with wheels. Thanks a lot, Capricorn Double Wide RV, you fucking shit for brains. Wheels, now I'm gonna buy. I thought maybe they didn't have wheels. It's only an RV, recreational vehicle.
They don't have a very good options package.
What, do people think it's a boat? I'm hungry, I guess. You wanna go get me something, Doug? You won't do that.
I gotta run the session.
Yeah, you don't give a shit about me. Talent's hungry, fuck him. That's all he's thinking in there. If there's anything going through its mind, it's fuck Bob Tulap. Fuck him and his copy.
You know I can hear you, right, Bob?
Huh?
You know that I can hear you.
Yeah, I do know you can hear me, Doug. Loud and clear, shit for brains. You fucknut. This is the shittiest ad I've ever heard. See the world during your retirement and put down a large deposit on a Capricorn Double Wide RV today. They're going fast, so call now. Capricorn, bringing the best in motorized vehicles since 1903. Where's the phone number? You know, they say call now. Where's the fucking phone number? They don't give it to you. What am I supposed to call, Capricorn Double Wide RV, fuckheads? I need a break.
Shorter.
I found a guy.
You mean that hairstylist?
Yeah, stylist.
So?
This place hasn't changed?
No, it looks the same.
Hey, I'm glad you came out. I wasn't sure.
I almost didn't.
I'm glad you did. I'm seeing a therapist. I've done a lot of thinking.
Mm-hmm.
I realized that I haven't always been a very supportive comedy partner.
Peter, you know, it was years ago. You don't have to worry about it.
I owe you an apology.
You don't owe me an apology. We're both to blame.
I need to get this off my chest.
Okay.
I'm sorry. It's not just that. Okay? I felt like there's this weight on my mind that I just need to get these things out there, okay? With me flaking on you and not returning your calls or your emails and disappearing. I don't know what it was. I was ashamed. I was ashamed. I was ashamed that I was letting you down and I became incapacitated, you know? I know you had such high ambitions for us and for our entertainments, and I did too. And then life just happened, and you know, there was the fire, and I had a kid, and I'm not making excuses, but I'm saying that it's just, I got stuck, and I felt like life was just kind of just crushing me, and I felt weak, and too weak to tell you.
Tell me what?
Pull my finger.
What?
Pull my finger.
No, I'm not gonna pull your finger.
Pull my finger.
That's why you wanted me to come out here and see you?
It's too late. It's gone.
You know what, man? I've been seeing a therapist, too. I learned that working with you did a lot of damage up here. And in here. Your absence was like a punch in the gut. And I sent you all these projects. I sent you these songs that I'd written, sketches, ideas for films, and you just never responded. Just totally disappeared.
Wait.
What, just what?
Pull my finger.
Fuck you, man.
No, come on, pull my finger. Oh, God, I'm sorry. Are you okay?
Jesus.
Are you alright? Oh, shit, I'm sorry. Are you okay? Are you...
Oh, why is it so hard? Oh. Oh.
Thank you all for coming. Now, as I'm sure you're all well aware, over the last several years, Jaguar sales have been in decline, and honestly, we don't know why. That's why I've hired Jack Taylor from McKenzie Consulting to perform some research into Jaguar's market. And now, he's gonna tell us exactly what that market wants. So without further ado, please welcome Jack Taylor.
All right, I know you're all busy. So I'm just gonna cut to the fucking chase. People want smaller Jaguars. Why? Well, if you think about it, it's obvious. They're afraid large Jaguars will eat their children. So you gotta make them smaller. Hmm? Let's get into it.
I'm gonna stop you real quick. You do realize we're talking about the luxury cars and not the jungle cats?
Look, all I'm saying is they have to be smaller.
Why?
Because that's what people want.
How do you know that?
Because we asked them. We conducted focus groups and surveys, and we asked them.
But did you ask them about luxury cars or jungle cats?
Cars? Obviously.
But you just said that people are afraid large Jaguars will eat their children?
It's a common expression.
Is it?
Look, what am I here to talk about? Am I here to talk about expressions? Or am I here to talk about cars?
I have no idea why you're here. Do you?
Okay. I can see what happened here. I made a mistake. Because I thought Jaguar was an open-minded company. I can see that's not the case, so I'll just take my fees and leave.
Hold on, Jack. No. Jack. Okay. Clearly, we got off on the wrong foot. Now, I know that Jack and his team spent a lot of time and money putting this report together, so let's just hear him out, all right?
Honestly, after that hostile reception, I think maybe we should just cool off, take a week, I'll make some tweaks.
Jack, please, we're all professionals here, all right? You know, why don't you just get right to the PowerPoint?
Honestly, just one more day.
One day. Jack, relax. I would love to see this PowerPoint presentation.
PowerPoint.
Okay, first slide. This is a metaphor, but it demonstrates what I'm trying to tell you, which is that people want smaller Jaguars. They're cuter, more stylish, whereas large Jaguars are harder to maintain. Next slide. Continuing the metaphor, this slide explains how proportional to the square of its weight, a larger car engine produces much more horsepower.
So you're telling us that's a bad thing?
Yes. Our research shows that people want less horsepower. Okay, next slide. So this is where the metaphor gets a little complicated.
Okay, guys, I'm done. Right, hold on, you guys. Now, I know this seems a little unorthodox, but McKinsey Consulting is the best. That's why I hired them.
Are you sure you don't mean McKinsey Consulting?
McKinsey is the best. Look, I promise this is going somewhere, right?
Right. Okay, next slide. Shrinking market share. Traction control. Symbols of excellence. In athletics. In money. And in cars. Which, of course, is the whole point of this presentation. So, any questions?
Wanted to take roll to get things started. Just make sure we're all present. We got a lot of work ahead of us, and I don't want anybody like slacking off. Tracy Mercier,
here.
Good. Okay. Our point man is Tracy. He's the go-getter. He's a quick sprinter.
I'm just really proud of the team. We've overcome a lot of adversity, and I'm really hopeful for the hopefuls.
frame, man.
Right here.
Olympics, 09. I mean, what can you say? I'm in the prime of my life. I'm only getting primer.
He's the scatterbrain of the bunch, but he's quick.
I'm 32. I do smoke, but I don't really think that's relevant. You know, I'll be 35 when the Olympics come, and really, that's ripe for running.
Trent Bixby is me. I'm third wheel, and that's how I'm in most friendships. You know, I go out with my friends a lot, and they have girlfriends. So that's a position that I'm comfortable with. Travis Harrington, and then we have our horse at the end, the horse at the workhorse who pretty much delivers the mail, and he is a mailman, which is good.
Tracy, we another one of the Perriers.
We've been training now for 4 or 5 years.
Go! Fantastic.
Obviously, we have a communication breakdown. It was very clear that we're getting red outfits, and we're going to be synced with red. And what's the deal with that?
It's red.
It's not red.
I'm a little embarrassed about my outfit. I thought, you know, we were all going to be wearing our original team uniforms. I'll go out and get some real red this week.
I'm glad you guys are out here to finally see how we're working and how we're adapting to these new rules that are going to change the sport forever. With accordance to the upcoming 2009 Summer Olympics, the following changes will be made with regards to track and field races and or events. Rule number 9, in the following events, the 100-meter, 200-meter, and 700-meter relay race, the baton will be replaced by a baby in a duffel bag. The baby can weigh no more than 15 pounds and no less than 3 pounds. Preemies are outlawed. Can't use a premature baby.
That's your rule right there.
That's good.
Yeah.
Your specific team can work with a baby of their choice, given these guidelines and rules. Tracy and his lovely wife have allowed us to get some practice runs in with the baby.
Yeah, he doesn't like to sit still. This guy likes a motor buddy.
I'm really excited that they opened up the sport now with babies, because I think we're going to do a lot better with the babies.
Baby, donut, bag, baton. What's the difference?
Well, major difference between working a baton and a baby is, well, there's the obvious. You have a human life versus an inanimate stick. All right, guys, let's do this.
Yep.
I thought it'd be a little easier, actually, but it's not. It's kind of awkward. The little guy kicks and squirms, you know.
You know, we've worked together so much, and being that this particular baby came from Travis's sperm, I think that's really going to just lock up and link up for us. And
okay.
Not a doubt in my mind that we're going to be ready in 09. I mean, we're a team.
What? No!
The baby, by the time, you know, 3 years the Olympics come, he's going to be ready to go.
It's the adapting that's really the important part. If we're comfortable with the baby, if we can do the passes with the baby, we're gonna keep our speed up.
What he needs to remember is that we're a team, and we live and die, you know, as a team. This is a team sport. It's not tennis or, you know, basketball or, you know, with that, what's that guy, the Kareem Abdul,
hey, what's that guy's name, guys? Kareem Abdul.
Outsender.
He's the ball player.
I have no idea who you're talking about.
As you know, I'm also the champion in the father-son hammer throw. I think I could probably throw him about 175 yards in competition.
Definitely the baton is lighter, it's thinner, it's made of wood. We lost ours, so we're using the wood one. A baby is thicker. It shits itself.
Hey, Tracy, I think he needs to be changed. He did a shit in the bag.
Woo!
Oh, yeah.
It breaks into practice a lot, because you have to change the baby, feed the baby. So there's a lot of things that we have to be extra careful with the baby. Well, I think if the baby falls to injury, or if any of us fall to injury, we just replace him.
We'll be right back.
a unit of five, and I'm happy to say that 09's gonna be our year.
We're gonna do well in the Olympics.
I think the Olympics are for me. I never knew it would be competing with my son and my friends, but for my country, you know, I'll do anything. And
and that's our team. We're the hopefuls, and we're hopeful that 09 is going to be a big year for us. And I think the Olympics, I think they're in Burbank that year, but I'm not positive. Again, I'm going to get another email.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Good job, guys.
Great race, guys.
Good job.
Yeah.
Orange slices, water.
And we have done it. We have done it.
We got through chunk four.
We did.
With no issues.
We were a little concerned about our good friend and father figure, John Williams, who personally did that score for us.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It sounds very much like the actual Olympic score that he wrote.
Yeah.
But it's slightly different.
Slightly different. So, look, those are all the films that we were going to screen. Let's talk about the last chunk. That was The Hopefuls, the Drama 3-4, old school one. I saw in the comments some people were giving us some Bruins in the house. We're a little upset, but, you know, they'll be okay. We also watched Jaguar. Chuck Armstrong. I got to talk about Chuck for 2 seconds. He is recovering from COVID in New York, and he was posting these stories about his medical updates. But he was also interjecting how amazing the movie Tombstone is. So it's a really, I don't know if his Facebook thing is public, but it was killing me. I was like, please do a short film about this. But he's much better. He's fine. We met Chuck and Charles when we were doing Carnal Desire, and he sent me a text. He saw something that reminded him of Carnal Desire. And then I said, hey, let's send us a flick. He sent us this and this other Beethoven one that's also hilarious. So find Charles. They're great. They have a website. Very talented. And then, of course, Franco and Billy.
I mean, what can you say about that that hasn't already been expressed?
I know.
So beautifully.
It really is the best fart joke I've ever
experienced,
I guess.
I don't know how you top it, like make the fart go longer.
No, it was 79 years. I don't know. I mean... Anyway, they're amazing. Wiens has been posting posting some quarantine videos on his Vimeo, I think on his Vimeo. And also Peter Blomquist everybody's been hanging out with Peter Blomquist in Red Dead Redemption. He plays, what's his character's name? Oh my God, I'm blanking. Yeah. Now somebody type it. It's in, oh my God, look,
someone
it's in the credit.
In the chat.
Yeah, I'm laughing. And then of course, Liam Sullivan is Bob Tulap. So, that's our almost scheduled program.
Almost.
A little hiccup there. And as I mentioned at the top of the show, we are working this out. And we apologize to any of the filmmakers for any of the compression issues and stuff like that. We are figuring out the best way to kind of spend some time with you guys from home. And, I think it came together pretty good. There's a couple of gaps in there with, tell people to scroll through. Also, we got a couple of donations. Thank you so much. Our Venmo is at Drama34Prod, Drama34Prod. If you wanna donate, we're gonna be donating to Save, oh my God, now I'm blanking on that. What's going on with my brain?
Something about
Save with Stories, which is a charity that Amy Adams and Jennifer Garner have put together where celebrities read children's books to help with some homeschooling. Also, check out our whole campaign. This is day 20. We're going to do, how many more events are we doing, Bryce? Four?
Oh, live streams? Yeah, I believe four.
We have four more. Actually, it's Monday and then Thursday, Monday and Thursday. So we've kind of taken over Mondays and Thursdays.
We kind of doubled down. We missed we had to skip a Thursday. So
yeah. But should I tell them what we're planning on doing? I guess we can, right? This for this crowd.
Yeah. Sure.
So we're gonna watch my feature film, The Basement in the Kitchen. That's gonna be next Monday. Then we're going to premiere the House Place pilot that we did a big event for at the Gary Marshall Theater last year, which has not been online before. So we're going to put that out. We're working out. We may have to work out some kinks. Maybe I don't promise this one yet. But we're going to try to watch IFC's the show we did for IFC, Fortune Rookie with Janet Varney. But maybe we'll have some Possum Death Spree issues. We'll see. As well as our last night on day 30. Well, I won't even talk about that. We'll make that a little bit of a surprise. But we're going to – Bryce and I are going to host another – kind of short film night in celebration of our 34-day nightmare that we created for ourselves. mainly for Bryce. How you doing, Bryce?
I'm doing all right.
Yeah.
It's a lot of technical tweaking,
but we're figuring it out.
It's worth it.
It is. It is. This has been very fun. So thank you again to all the filmmakers for letting us show your stuff. Please look in, click all the links and find all the peoples. Thank you to Tara, Jayn, and John Mattingly for watching along and making sure everybody got their information. What else, Bryce?
I don't know. Just keep coming back and see more of our 34 days.
Yeah. Travel back in time these last 20 days and see a ton of our stuff.
Yeah,
and then
go to drama34.com/34days. And, you can go back through everything we've done so far. You can watch Stickbone 12 in its entirety.
Yeah.
You can watch a lot more Bob Tulaps. And,
Oh, you know, we should do that, Bryce, not to put more work on your plate, but we should do links. We can do links on the offline, like direct links for all these movies that aren't ours.
Today's whole lineup, I intend to, the ones that are still online. Some are not, like Possum Death Spree and like Holy Wine. Actually, I think Possum Death Spree is online. Gareth was trying to post a link to it. So
what's up, Adam Films? Come on, I'm going to call iFilm, and yell at
that was a thing.
Yeah. Those were the original ones.
So yeah, we'll have this whole thing there. So anything you missed, or that YouTube
glitched
prevented
up.
You from seeing, you can see where it actually lives, and not in our live stream.
Yeah.
In top quality.
Well, that was a fun Thursday.
Yeah. Thanks for joining us, everybody.
Yeah, hope you guys had fun. And I'll definitely check out Natalie and Tara Try Stuff, by the way, Panic Button and that whole crew, because they've been so awesome helping us figure out all this stuff. They've been doing a lot of live stuff, so please check out their stuff as well and follow them. And follow us on our Instagrams, at Drama34Prod and at DFickus. And are you B. Beckham or Bryce Beckham?
Bryce Beckham.
We have a Facebook page. We have all that crap. All that stuff. Anyway, that's all. All right, we're done. Let's have a cocktail.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.